1 2 3
नमस्कार। मेघश्यामं पीतकौशेयवासं श्रीवत्सांकं कौस्तुभोद्भासितांगं पुण्योपेतं पुंडरीकायताक्षं विष्णुं वंदे सर्वलोकैकनाथं। सिंसियर प्रणाम्स टू दी ओम्निप्रेजेंट ऑल पावरफुल गॉड मेघश्याम टू इंस्पायर इग्नाइट एंड इंस्टिल the courage, confidence and strength in all of us to conduct anything that is good. Namaste, respected guest of the evening and all the respected audiences out there watching us. Shri Sai Raman Nritya Kendra Tumakuru deems it a great pleasure and an honor to present this thought-inspiring webinar series, Sankatha, a conversation with internationally acclaimed male dancers, an initiative of Rasagrahi. And today, as began the show with Meghashyama, we have a personification of that God's energy, Mithuna Shyama, as our guest of honor. A warm welcome to you, Guru Mithun Shyam, sir.
Namaste.
It's indeed
namaste.
A pleasure to have you here. Namaste, sir. A warm welcome to you. And thanks a ton for all our audiences for joining us so kindly, so patiently. Every time we host any program from Rasagrahi, you bless, you support, and you inspire us. Thank you so much, and a warm welcome to all of you. A very warm and dear welcome to our captain, Vidwan Sagar Tumakuru, who has been a very able dancer, natuvanar, singer. Though he doesn't accept it, I know for sure the quality work that he does is something very commendable and something very admirable. A very hearty welcome to you, sir.
Thank you, ma'am. Thank you.
It is indeed a great, you know, John Keats says, a thing of beauty is a joy forever. And God has bestowed me with too much joy each time talking about the achievements of a consummate artist, talking about their journey towards success. And I'm so thankful to the Lord and my gurus for instilling this confidence and for giving me this opportunity to do this. Without any delay, I now take this opportunity to very respectfully talk about the humongous sadhana by Mithun Shyam sir. Though he is very hesitant to listen to any of these things, I mean, he stays to his roots. He is so down to earth a person. He says, madam, just mine and my guru's name is enough. But fearing the failure on my part as an anchor, I try talking respectfully about his very profound sadhana. This is Sankatha, a conversation with internationally acclaimed male dancers. Guru Mithun Shyam has had the privilege of training under the inimitable Kirti Shesha Guru Padmini Ramachandran ma'am for over 25 years, which in itself is a big sadhana. Having the right kind of a guru and having to pursue the art form or the learning for a very extended period itself is a great sadhana. And Mithunji has excelled in doing it because he's always believed that guru is everything. And we have seen him whenever he talks, he walks, he performs, he says guru is everything. And that is what has made him what he is. Guru Padmini Ramachandran ma'am has grown him into a fine performer, a dedicated teacher, a creative choreographer, and a deserving torchbearer among the very few noteworthy male performers for the Valavur Bani of Bharatanatyam. Mithun Shyam ji garnered rave reviews for his solo thematic performances such as Sudarshanam, Purushantargataha, and has presented critically acclaimed traditional performances across the globe. Apart from being a soloist, he has been a very greatly sought after lead artist in mega productions by renowned choreographers like Padma Shri awardees Guru Ananda Shankar Jayant ma'am, veteran actress Hema Malini ma'am, and many, many others. Mithun Shyam ji is an A grade artist of Doordarshan, and he is an empanel member of ICCR. an embellished impaneled artist of ICCR. He runs a successful dance institute called Vaishnavi Natyashala, which imparts training to sincere students. And each time I see his students, my heart goes out to appreciate all those tiny thoughts and appreciate the guru for having instilled so much of purity in their movements, so much of cuteness in their abhinaya. And this school really excels in training, in imparting training in Bharatanatyam. Mithun Shyam sir, it's a great honor having you on board here, and we shall await a very inspiring session from both our very dazzling male performers, Mithun Shyam sir and Sagar Tumakuru sir. The floor is all yours, and we shall await your discussion. Om Namaste.
Thank you so much. Thank you so much, Rupashree ma'am, for that beautiful intro.
My honest, thank you.
I joined Mithun sir for joining, thanking Rupashree ma'am so wonderfully every day without any kind of, you know, hindrance. She accepts the duty of, like a duty, she does it, and it's been giving a lot of glory to the whole session itself. And she brings the power and that, you know, the good start to every conversation we have. Correct. Thank you so much, Rupashree ma'am. God bless you with all required in abundance.
Thank you, Sagar. It's just not duty, but my beauty also. The beauty of the sadhana of these artists is something that drives me to do this. And thank you for the opportunity. Kindly start with the conversation.
Thank you, ma'am. Mithun sir, first of all, thank you so much for accepting the invitation to be part of this Sankatha series of conversation with male dancers across the globe. And we are very proud to have you on the board, one among the proud artists of our own state of Karnataka. So welcome you on board.
Thank you, Sagar. Don't call me sir, then I'll also have to call you sir.
Okay.
Yeah.
Thank you for that lenience also given on officially on board.
Yes.
So that's nice one. So yeah, so as all of us are almost in a contemporary age of, you know, dwelling in the same kind of boat, almost the same transitions which we have seen, I think the discussions would be very, very personal in that sense. So let's start off your journey of, you know, how did you get introduced to this art form? Because, you know, I think it was in the 80s and 90s, probably you would have been end of 80s and beginning of the 90s are the age I think we all got initiated into dance, where it was an age of, you know, great transition, you know, the Western dance, and the Michael Jackson was in his peak at that point of time, and everywhere it was like, you know, the film competitions and film songs, film dance were at its peak, and somewhere we, like, you know, a small tiny thoughts, we still got induced, and also a lot of different kind of challenges because of the globalizing world, which we saw in the 90s, as taking up dance as a profession or to dance itself as a male dancer.
Yeah.
So can you please tell us about your exciting journey?
What you said is right, but more than Michael Jackson, for me, I think it was Mithun Chakraborty. My parents were great fans of his. So they named him also, named me also Mithun. And Mithun, on top, and actually what happened was 1990, to be exact, my sister joined dance class. And okay. I used to, me and my brother were her bodyguards, picking her up and dropping her and all that. Hage, what happened is, but when she used to dance, I used to look at her, and when the teacher was correcting her, I used to sit there and do the actions. Seeing that, my first teacher, Guru Airavati, she told me, you can as well get up and start dancing. That's better. So even now, that habit has not gone for me. If I see anybody dancing, even now, my body just expressions and all, it'll just come. So avaglu hange idde. So that's how it started off. Then after about 2 years of training under Airavati miss, then she left to America. And before going, she had told, never discontinue your dance. And then my mother and father, they came to know of Padmini ma'am in Hutchins Road, which is nearby in Cockstown. And that's how we started with Padmini ma'am, and then rest is history. That's how it started off.
That's great. I think you are one of the few I have heard, because this is a review which I'm giving you, who have retained something which has been composed then, because every time now is an age of adding something about ours in the everything, in even in a little bit of changes, and you say this is my contribution to the Adavus, this is my choreography, the original is there, and you add on. But I've heard a great review about Mithun, that you have retained all the compositions of what's been learned from Padmini ma'am. And now my question to you is, why did you do it, and what made you so influential about those traditional choreographies?
I'll tell you. When I went to Padmini ma'am, like all of us, she, our guru, no, she became my ultimate idol. For me, she was perfect beyond any, you know, mistake. She was, I looked up to her for everything. So once when she was teaching me this one jati, it's like this, it's an old jati. So she told me this jati, I love it very much, because this Varur Ramay Pillai sir taught it to me. So Mithun, you keep this jati like this only forever. Because I learned it from my guru like this, you also keep it like this, Anta, she had told me. That is when that germ of thing that came into my mind, you know, that I have to retain what my teacher teaches me as it is. So any of the thing that she has taught me, nangange memory nali, it is on seal haki kutirotara. I can't change it. I don't think I can do anything to make it better. To be frank, that is what I feel. Her Jagan Mohan Natana Raja Sabhapati Irli, Parkadal Alemin Irli, whether her Koravanji, which is a production, early, her Jatisurams, what she taught me early, Varnam Niyandamayam, how she taught me early, all these things, I don't think I can do anything to make them better, because they look so perfect as they are.
Yes, they are.
So I don't touch anything that she has in the 25 years, what I learned from her, I keep it exactly as it is. Then of course, what I do now, I have to always make new dances for me, which is like I worked on Jagadananda Karaka, Tyagaraja Kritis, Jagadananda Karaka, new Tillanas that I work on or anything. I think I sit and I think, what would ma'am have done? If ma'am was sitting, what kind of Adavu she would have put here? What kind of Abhinaya she would have done? So because when you literally live with a person for 25 years, you kind of know them. There used to be a time, I should tell you this, I could sit outside the class, and before ma'am says anything to her student, I could tell what she's going to tell. So Harugane, we used to have fun. I would say, see, no, ma'am will tell this, and all the parents there would laugh, because I could predict what she's going to tell, how she will shout, or what she's going to appreciate, I would say. So Ashtu, I had understood her thought process, how she liked to create things, what she liked. Anta, there's another experience also similar to that. Me and Minu, we were doing a duet. So now Vidru, ma'am had told something, hinging madu, Mithun, you do it. So Minu also had said, then we were practicing Madurai program time. I said, no, let's do it like this, let's do it. Minu said, no, we have to do it like this. Then finally, when ma'am checked it, she was like, what have you done? Do it like this. And the exact what I had told we will do, same thing ma'am came about telling. So I realized that now I know exactly how ma'am thinks. So I just stick to that, because for me, I find that very, very beautiful. Not that I don't find other teachers or compositions beautiful, but in my body, what I have learned for my style, because she made me an individualistic dancer. So that individuality, I am able to enjoy a lot. I relish it a lot. I think I maintain
nice. That. So, yeah, that is, I think, brings us to, again, deciphering a fact that the belief in the guru is very important as you, learn. But does it remain same with everybody? And how do you deal with your students now? And, getting that confidence on a teacher in this era of digital, I mean, now digital, even 2 years before, it was a very fast running world. And you being trained under a single guru for 20 to 25 years, and now probably I think in Bangalore the scenario is 2 years, one guru, maybe for one item, one guru, and another item, another guru, or something like that. I've heard that it's going on. So what's your take on such a situation which is happening now?
See, how I am is just me. I don't like to impose that on anybody else. I never demand that of my students. They like to learn anywhere. I have absolutely no problem with it. I'm very happy when they go and do whatever. And when they come back and they show me the dance that they learned, I just give them the feedback. it is not suiting you. You're looking ditto like that person. No, you change this. You change this. Make it like you. And then a frank feedback could be thing. And the students understand me really well. They know that I don't have any hard feelings. I accept them as they are. But there are some things, they will go to a workshop, they'll imitate that person and come back. Hange martare, because that is how many in workshop. I mean, they don't have the time to bring individuality and all. Our own kaltidara, our body nal choreograph maditare, hange kalsibittare. ಅದು ಒಂಥರ ಫೀಲ್ ತರ ಇವ್ರು ಕಲ್ಕೊಂಡು ಬರ್ತಾರೆ ನಾನು ಅದನ್ನೆಲ್ಲ ಚೆನ್ನಾಗಿ ಚೇಂಜ್ ಮಾಡಿ ಮಾಡಿಫೈ ಮಾಡಿ ಐ ಪುಟ್ ಮೈ ಮೇಕಪ್ ಆನ್ ಇಟ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಸೇ ಓಕೆ ನೌ ಯು ಗೋ ಡು ಇಟ್
ನೋ ದಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಒನ್ ಪಾರ್ಟ್ ಲರ್ನಿಂಗ್ ಇನ್ ವರ್ಕ್ಶಾಪ್ ಇಸ್ ಒನ್ ಪಾರ್ಟ್ ದ ಸೀರಿಯಸ್ ಎರರ್ ನವ ಡೇಸ್ ಪೀಪಲ್ ಆರ್ ಡೂಯಿಂಗ್ ಇಸ್ ಒನ್ಸ್ ದೇ ಲರ್ನ್ ದ ಬೇಸಿಕ್ ಫ್ರಮ್ ಸಂಬಡಿ ದೇ ಸ್ಟಾಪ್ ಗೋಯಿಂಗ್ ಟು ರೆಗ್ಯುಲರ್ ಕ್ಲಾಸ್ ಯು ಆರ್ ಟಾಕಿಂಗ್ ಅಬೌಟ್ ಸಂಬಡಿ ಗೋಯಿಂಗ್ ಫಾರ್ ಅಡಿಷನಲ್ ನಾಲೆಜ್ ಆಫ್ ಐಟಮ್ಸ್ ಟು ಸಂಬಡಿ I'm not talking about that scenario, but there are some people whom I have even seen and I've got a call even saying that I want to learn only that item. How many months and how many days and what's the fees? I just want to learn that item from you and the other item I learn from somebody else and things like that. So I was talking about that kind of a scenario.
What happens in that case is maybe a different kind of a style will develop. Nange, I don't know. I don't understand how that works. See, workshop still acceptable, but jump not having an identity.
Yeah.
Guru Parampara yeah. is something that I really don't know. I don't know. So if any student of mine wants to go learn under somebody else, first of all, they ask me, Yaratra Hogbeko Yenuanta, if they are moving or whatever. Anan full research madi Yaratra Hogbeko Antala Nani Helkot Pertini. Go here. There is a very good guru. You learn from them. Anta Nani Helkot Pertini. But I don't like them learning there for 1 or 2 years, then coming back to me, I don't think I would like. Yaro atara bandilla, bandre, I don't know how I would handle it. They may have to start again all over. But I'm not the type which will say, illa, beda, get out of my sight. Atara yenu helala. Bandre, I will have to. There was one child who came back. And I don't know how to say no. Because vidya namdalla do. Bharatanatyam is not mine. It is just passing through me. And I'm so lucky that while it was passing, it touched me and it's come, no? So there's one student who came to me, nan gotte illa, yen madbeku, yen madbeku. Should I accept? Because manasinalli, you have gone to somebody else, you have to learn from that person is what I believe. But after 1 month coming back to me, I didn't know how to think. So I didn't want to be egoistic also. So nan yen madde, very simple method ide adike. I wrote a chit, yes and no. Yer chit madde. I did like this and said, go put in front of Nataraja, take one chit and come. Oga haki tagon bandaga no anta bantu. I said, you can leave. I can't. Nataraja re helbettidare. I can't do anything about it. So that's the kind of system I follow when I can't really think about it. But generally, yaradru bandaga, I'm absolutely fine. Nanage adella yenu problem illa.
Okay. That's nice that you are open to people, but I think it's for them to decide whether. What they are doing, they have to be very cautious at this point of time of what choices they are making. I think that is what I can sense from
their biggest loss is the biggest loss is they lose individuality and they lose an identity. That is their loss. Nanike, I am very proud of my identity as a disciple of Guru Padmini Ramachandran, who is a disciple of Valvu Ramya Pillai. So I love that identity that I have and I celebrate that. Yes. And I would never want to lose that for anything under the sun. Not even if somebody tells me, Nini alho kaltre ninge e award barute, award barute, you'll become a famous nan bekage illa. I love this identity that I have and I'll never lose it for anything.
That's true. I think, we should congratulate you for that. And that's, I think, very important.
No, it's just
for
me. I don't know if it's good or bad. I'm not saying it's good or bad. It's just that I like it like that personally.
I think it is the far truth also at the end of the day, because the roots are very important for anybody to grow and find their thing. So identity comes, the word you have already coined it. I think identity is very important. From where do we come and who are we is very important in the field.
Exactly. How do.
So that becomes very important. Talking so much about, learning under one guru and lineage, which you just said, what is your belief of, what's a bani? Because there is a lot of other definitions, but what is a bani or a style for you?
See, mine is the Vazhuvoor bani.
Yes.
But When I asked my ma'am about Bani, all she said is there is good dancing, bad dancing. Yerde Bani. Olle dancer, ketta dancer. Ashte. If it is good, people will watch you. If it is not good, people will not watch you. Adni yav Bani adrunu sari. Within Varur Bani, there are good dancers, bad dancers. So it is not the Bani that defines you. What defines you is what kind of a dancer you are. That said, Varur Bani has its own particular, some stylized things. Post kododagli, on swalpa glamorized, if you want to call it that. Glamorous and abhinayakke ontara chamakkarika abhinaya, very lokadharmiish abhinaya where kannalla madodala swalpa lokadharmi tara irutte. Adu tumba graceful agi, beautiful agi, salilatavagirutte, sulalitavagirutte. And that kind of beauty is embodied, the way we stand and all the, I like it. I think ella bani nodidaga nanage anusutte, I like this very much. I just feel I'm very lucky. The dance chose me and put me in the correct place with the correct teacher, with the correct style, which just sat on me so well. I feel like that. So that is Bani. So Bani is a very individualistic thing, how a person dances. But if you look at the parampara Bani, parampara of Bani, you will have certain features. Like, see, we are all, maybe my eyes are like my mother. My smile like me, maybe like the father. Otherwise comes as a bani in the sprinkled things. But ultimately, you are an individualist thing, and that is your thing. That's it. Bani is just that genes antarala atara.
Yeah,
I have the Vadubur genes.
That's so nice. So I think, do you accept that even these kind of things are transforming? Even before the Banis were formed, and even now, the things are slowly flowing like a river, and they have been taking a lot of turns and coming in and out and in and out. So do you accept changes? Because there is a cult of people who say that, okay, no, this is wrong. As you rightly mentioned, such a broad-minded guru you had, that she said that there's something good and there's something bad. That is another completely a very optimistic view of looking at dancing. And I think we can be more at the receiving end, as you rightly said, if it is like, you know, said that it is good and bad. But there is a cult of people who even say that you need to stand at this angle and this is the way you need to walk and this is correct and this is wrong. So do you believe in saying, you know, Bani as a rider to say it is a good or a bad dance?
From my experience of having met so many people, the people who say right and wrong, no, they, I mean, I please generally take what I'm telling is just my opinion.
Yes.
Don't judge me. I don't want to generalize it. From the majority of the people who have said it is right or wrong, what I have personally noticed is they're using it as an excuse for mediocrity. Neening madre idu tappu avarella maatadru over agide hingide hangide antala heltaralla, that is a kind of excuse for their own mediocrity to hide. So because they are not getting the popularity, because they are not getting that what the other person has or what somebody has developed or something, that some formula that has worked for somebody, when they don't get that, they say it's wrong. That's wrong. What they're doing is not correct. We are the correct ones. We are the traditional ones. What we do is only correct. And hang heloro, majority na nodiroro are mediocre. Because when you are amazing, when you're really good at your art, no, you don't need those excuses of somebody's right or wrong. When you're good, people will come to watch you.
That's a good thing. So you mean to say that they are insecure about their place?
Insecure.
Yeah. Okay,
correct.
Okay.
That's the right word. Yes. They are feeling that something's wrong with them. So they try to say others are wrong. Why can't you do, when if you do what you're doing well, people will come. It's like what my teacher said, Chenna Gitre Nortar, Ad Yav Bani Irli, Yav Style Irli, Nivesh Height Irli, Nivesh to Yene Size Shape Yene Irli. If what you do is good, you will have your audience. You will have people love your art. That's all. That is the line to it. Ashte. You can't compare, you can't tell why that person has it. ತುಂಬಾ ಜಂಪ್ ಮಾಡೋದ್ರಿಂದ ಅವನು ಮಂಡಿ ಹೋಗೋದ್ರಿಂದ ಅವನು ಈ ತರ ಆಕ್ರೋಬ್ಯಾಟಿಕ್ಸ್ ಮಾಡೋದ್ರಿಂದ ವಾಟ್ ಇಸ್ ನಾಟ್ ದೇರ್ ಇನ್ ನಾಟ್ಯಶಾಸ್ತ್ರ ಸೋ ಮೆನಿ ಟೈಮ್ಸ್ ಐ ಫೀಲ್ ಲೈಕ್ ಆಸ್ಕಿಂಗ್ ವಾಟ್ ಇಸ್ ನಾಟ್ ದೇರ್ ಇನ್ ನಾಟ್ಯಶಾಸ್ತ್ರ ದಟ್ ವಿ ಆರ್ ಡೂಯಿಂಗ್ ಅಲ್ವಾ ಸೊ ಇಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಕ್ಯೂಸ್ ಫಾರ್ ಮೀಡಿಯೋಕ್ರಿಟಿ ಹೌದು or insecurity, like you said.
So I think that's a very good thought which you have put across to all of us, saying that following any style is not wrong, but denying somebody else's dance with your riders as a bani, or it might be style or something which is good or bad even, I think shows your mediocrity or your insecurity to accept something which is being done as an experiment. Or
why I'm
as
telling a... why I'm telling is, I've heard many children who used to 2-3 years yellow kalthbato, when they have come to me, they've told that their teacher used to say, I'll hope beda, or the style, or the dance, or the Bharatanatyam, or the idu antala. I was like, what? I mean, I can't be more Bharatanatyam than most Bharatanatyam people right now. So I'm like, it's Bharatanatyam. But they're like, then I realized that it is because there maybe they didn't have that, I don't know what you call it, insecurity.
Yes.
Because it is a lot of hard work, Sagar, you know it. See, to learn dance is one thing. Just to learn dance, can you be anything in your life? No. You have to have music knowledge. Then Devro has to give you that personality to be able to talk, to be able to present your dance well, to be able to face an audience well, to have knowledge of so many languages, to have creativity. Idella Devro kodbekalva. And you have to practice it, and you have to work so hard. It's such a difficult work. And when somebody does all that and goes ahead, some people who are not able to do all that due to any personal or professional reasons, sometimes are not feel get hard feelings. I think so. So they say such things.
That's a lovely point which you put across, and very you're very cute in your answers.
Straightforward. I'm being straightforward. Yeah. I know it, I'm not being diplomatic. I'm just saying it how I have felt it.
Yeah. So now you have learnt under a single guru for a long, I mean, all 2 decades and more to it. So how do you see this kind of a traditional education, a guru and a shishya, that kind of a learning, along with these exam oriented learning? I mean, you would have also, I mean, cleared some exams and things like that. But how important do you find now, after everything, we have just crossed that decade of exams, and now we are there, okay, I'm done, and we let me dance starts. So how do you relook at your stages of exams as targets to learn? And I think sometimes it is good or bad. What is your viewpoint on having exams in the life of learning dance?
Sagar, I'm just loving your questions. Really, really. It's so different. So many interviews kotirthivi, and sometimes we feel that your same thing, maybe I have to say again. But these are so different, fresh. Tumba chanagide questions. And okay, let me answer this, because
because we come from same zone and same age group, probably. Correct. Think thoughts would be different. So I don't want to ask you the same questions, don't worry.
I'll tell you how my teacher did. I don't know if I can do like that. Auro, when she sent us for exams, you know what, she would teach each of us different devarnamas, each of us different jatis for us. Imagine the patience of the person. ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಹೋದ್ರೆ ಒಂದು ಕ್ಲಾಸ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ 20 ಜನ ಬಂದಿರ್ತಾರೆ, 20 ಜನನು ಸೇಮ್ ದೇವರನಾಮ ಸೇಮ್ ಜತಿ ಸುರ ಮಾಡ್ತಾರೆ. ಐ ಲೆಟ್ ಮೀ ಬಿ ಫ್ರಾಂಕ್, ಐ ಆಮ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ಡೂಯಿಂಗ್ ದಟ್ ಬಿಕಾಸ್ ಐ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಡೂ ದಟ್. ಮೈ ಮ್ಯಾಮ್, ನಾವು 10 ಜನರನ್ನ 11 ಜನರನ್ನ ಕಳಿಸಿದ್ರು, 22 ದೇವರನಾಮ ಶಿ ಸ್ಯಾಟ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಟಾಟ್ ಅಸ್. ಇಮ್ಯಾಜಿನ್, ಈಚ್ ಆಫ್ ಅಸ್ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಟು ಡೂ ಡಿಫ್ರೆಂಟ್ ಡಿಫ್ರೆಂಟ್. ದೇರ್ ವಾಸ್ the singers
and all, time for practice,
look at how much she invest, how much time she invested in us. Just imagine, obbobrige different.
I know,
nanage Jagan Mohan Krishna matte inondo what did I do, I don't remember, Jagan Mohan Krishna and I think Shivando, I did one.
Chandrachuda
irbeku, I don't know, I don't remember. Clearly this is 94 95. I don't remember. Then for my friends, Palisamma ide, oh, so many. Baro Krishnaya ide. 22 different. I don't remember that many different devanamas for each of them. Jatiswaras, even if we, if four of us are doing the same jatiswar, different adavus. You should not do the same.
Oh, okay.
Bere bere kalthodo. Bere bere thala haki madodo. I was like, mama, this lady, so much she is doing for junior exam. Not even vidvat. Junior exam, that is all. So did you see how the academic plus traditional came through? true. Yeah. She would not fall for that academic institutionalized horse thing. Hakodela. Adu hange idrunu adralli she will bring out the beauty of it. I am guilty. I'm not able to do like that because the 25 30 jana nan kalisuvaga I am not able to. I stick to two devanamas, two thing. But after that, apart from that, in the class, they learn different. But exam, it is easier to do like that, and I do. But my teacher didn't do that. It was inconvenient for the singer. It was inconvenient for the examiners. It was inconvenient for the students. We couldn't practice together, nothing. But look at how she used to think. She couldn't bring herself to put one line and stand on it. She was like that.
That's so great about her, to know about her.
She was like that. But so to answer the complete question, I like the institutionalized approach for theory because they get to learn the Abhinaya Darpana, Natya Shastra, all clear agi shloka jyothi kaliyo is very, very important. And because of the exams, they will sit and study that. Then after that, we can sit and concentrate on the dance aspect. As teachers, I like to sit and work on the performance part of it.
Theory part.
There are many dance classes which I think concentrate exclusively on exams. Andre ondond varsha there will be 10 people for junior exam, 10 20 people for senior exam. So they just go in that format. That I don't know, maybe they may not be able to create in solo dancers as such, but otherwise I think knowledge is knowledge, Alva. We can't put it down. Knowledge is knowledge.
You mean to say exams actually give some targets for students to just approach learning, but as teachers it's our duty to bring in that kind of sense of creativity and also variety of what can be done instilled in the students. So because especially I think in the whole country we should be very proud that Karnataka government was the first one to have these exams which came up with senior and Vidwat exams, which have come up, and great initiative which was taken long ago. I think it also has some good facilities, so we can have choice of our own gurus, because the present institutionalized learning which is going on, like diploma courses and UGPG courses which are going, have lacked that kind of a thing. So you join the university, there are teachers and they will teach you. But this system, I think, has that kind of flexibility. You can learn from anybody and then pass over the exam. Okay. So I think, your viewpoint of your exams are, great. I think it's good. And we've heard that you are a wonderful teacher. I've heard that. especially training the younger lot. I think that's very, we have seen some of the presentations of your younger lot, because after learning for 8 years, 9 years, performing debuts and all, in a group presentation would be okay. They are also at the age of 15, 16 and 17. They have some responsibility on stage also when they come up. So that is different case, but 10 years, 8 years, 7 years and 9 years, that we call in Kannada muddu putanigalu, we call them. Whatever they do on stage looks very cute and presentable, but then your productions or presentations are way far ahead, and the smile, the looks, not everybody, but at least the formula is taught to everyone. So can we know the secret of that teaching?
I've been blessed with some really wonderful, wonderful, wonderful students. I've been blessed. Just not how, namge, not only you should have a good teacher, you should also have good students. I have been blessed with some excellent students. I won't be wrong if I have to say I'm a fan of many of my own students. Avrash dedication nangilvella anta ansibidute ondon sari. They practice so much. They do their abhinaya so sincerely. They have so many questions. Such beautiful students I've had. Many of them, I think, many of the people, they are quite popular when they dance and all. They are very interested and they love to do. So my proudest moment was once one competition somewhere, competition program somewhere, one child went and danced. And they were thinking, they called me saying, today Padmini ma'am's one student came here. This is after ma'am had passed away. So I was like, Padmini ma'am's student bandra, yaro. Then she's like, Yeah, but when we gave the when we were announcing, she said she's a student of Mithun Shyam. But when we saw her, we were like, this is Padmini Ramachandran's student. They only dance like this, Anta. They had that thing. So I was so proud that day because I've been able to give that to, and I got such a good student to whom I could give that.
Give
So
that.
that way, I've got very good students. There is no, I think there's no secret to it. Secret enuilla. Marcy, 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 barlebek. So you should have that student who is willing to take that much of pressure that you put on them. That's all.
No, you should not stop at that because Marcy, Marcy, and there is another way to look at it also. Years together, Marcy Dine Marstertare. So that is also not accepted. But because, I can
Alala,
see
Marsodu andre, what I mean to say is
very short span
give
of
them,
time. Yeah.
yeah. Give them
Inputs.
everything, give the, all sides of it, how you can do one the same thing in five ways, Anta. So how again I should tell is when my teacher used to teach also, she would teach one whole padam. And ad mugisibittu 3 days chennak practice maadibittu bappa anta heltare na chennak practice maadibittu hodmele full she will change it. Ivaga innu chennagide hogi practice maadibittu ba. Again she will come. Before program in 3 din irutte full she will change it. So what happens is your brain gets rewired like one mad. Okay, nan ranga pravesha kang madidru, forget normal programs, ranga pravesha she did like that. So what happened is she taught me one item, ide item anta adanna maadi ella ready maadi, some 3 4 days before the arangitam she said, no, I don't like this item, I heard another song yesterday, kirtana tandidlo music adanna hakbitu id kalisibidu anta. Imagine the tension she's putting you through. Pressure. Then she made me do that for the Arangetam. But that came out really well. So when you do that with, that's what I meant by, not doing the same thing over and over again. Changing the whole thing, altering everything, breaking the breaking that one wall that they have in front of them, adana purti break maadibittu, show them something else altogether. They might get very frustrated, irritated with you because they don't know that you're working on their creativity, they're working on their individuality. Adala avaru gottagalla. ಯಾಕೆ ಸರ್ ಹಿಂಗ್ ಮಾಡ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದಾರೆ, ಏನೋ ಕಲಿಸಿದ್ದಾರೆ, ಅವರೇ ಎಲ್ಲ ಚೇಂಜ್ ಮಾಡ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದಾರೆ ಅಂತ ದೇ ಮೈಟ್ ಥಿಂಕ್. ಬಟ್ 20 ಇಯರ್ಸ್ ಲೇಟರ್ ದೇ ವಿಲ್ ರಿಯಲೈಸ್ ಲೈಕ್ ಹೌ ವಿ ಆಲ್ ರಿಯಲೈಸ್ಡ್.
That's so nice to hear this from you, but it's a great that shows your efforts as a teacher. Though you might be very humble saying that, no, I don't spend much time, I don't dedicate so much time as your students, but I asked this question to prove yourself false that you're also a very dedicated teacher. Because if there is no time given, because time is that very important thing, and second thing which you mentioned is the input, right time, right input to the right student. I think that also improvises them a lot. Otherwise, if we don't correct them at certain point of time, the same mistake goes on and on, and it develops in the future. As the good also develops, the bad also keeps on developing. It's a wonderful thought, Mithun. And secondly, talking about charm of Padmini ma'am. Any performance, as you rightly just mentioned, that this is the style of Padmini ma'am. That's what even the whole, all of us, because Karnataka was not that exposed to Valavur Bani before the performances of Padmini ma'am. And we got a definition kind of a thing. Okay, this is that vibrant, Bani, which we got to know in this region of Karnataka. So, can you just discuss some of them, like which are like the style of Padmini ma'am, which you have also adopted in your general performances or choreographies, not the technical adavu sorts or something, like in the way the presentations do happen.
See, hers, I'll tell you a few of the things. One action maadiro tara, inond action maadala. The first action is one, the second action will be totally different. So each line will become like a Sanchari Bhava. So illi
So
maadide, alli maadodu, she doesn't like.
there's no
No
symmetry.
repetition. No symmetry. No repetitions. Vibrance. It should not drop at any point of time. You should retain the same energy from the beginning to the end. Then the jati helodralli aa irodond vibrance ide. Avaru relax aagi jati helode illa. So it creates a kind of a vibrant and ellaru ಎಲ್ರಿಗೂ ಆಡಿಯನ್ಸ್ ಅಲ್ಲೆಲ್ಲ ಏನಾಗ್ತಾ ಇದೆ ಅಂತ ಇರಬೇಕು. ಆ ತರ ವಾಸ್ ಹರ್ ಎನರ್ಜಿ ಅಂಡ್ ವೈಬ್ರೆನ್ಸ್ ದಟ್ ಶೀಸ್ ಟು ಬ್ರಿಂಗ್ ಇನ್ ಅವರ್ ಕೊರಿಯೋಗ್ರಫೀಸ್. ಅಂಡ್ ವಾಟ್ ಟು ಸೇ, ಜನರಲ್ ಆಗಿ ಹೇಳಬೇಕು ಅಂದ್ರೆ, ಅಂಡ್ ದೆನ್ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಪ್ರೆಷನ್ಸ್ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಪ್ರೆಷನ್ಸ್ I have had a big problem with during my school times competition hogogalla, because the way ma'am used to teach was not very natya dharmi dharmi tara idond action hing maadi hing maadi hing maadi hing maadi, many of it would be subtly with the face itself. Artha aagtidya? So you don't have to use a hasta to do it, you can just tell with your face itself, you do your abhinaya and you go away from there. So that kind of thing she used to do. And she used to actually adhere to all the abhinaya darpana irodralli, because she used to make us use of our lips, she used to make us use of our eyes and eyelids, she used to make us use of our eyebrows, which was, I don't know why, cut out from dance in general. I don't know, jaasti nodidaga ellaru face ondara flat agi ittirtare, neat agi action right ge left ge center ge maartta iddru. From what I know, I am not blaming, I am not saying, I am just showing the difference because you asked me. So they used to do like that. Namd hang irta irilla. ನಾವು ಕಣ್ಣು ಹುಬ್ಬು ಎಲ್ಲ ಲಿಪ್ಸ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ವಿ ಹ್ಯಾಡ್ ಟು ಡು. ಸೊ ದ ವೇ ಶಿ ಯೂಸ್ ಟು ಬ್ರಿಂಗ್ ದಟ್ ಶೈನೆಸ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಆಲ್, ವಿ ಯೂಸ್ ಟು ಬಿ ಲೈಕ್ ಓ ಮೈ ಗಾಡ್ ಹೌ ವಿಲ್ ವಿ ಡೂ ಲೈಕ್ ದಿಸ್ ಬಿಕಾಸ್ ವಿ ಆರ್ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಪೋಸಿಂಗ್ ಅವರ್ ಸೆಲ್ಸ್ ಅಲ್ವಾ ಅಂತ ಆ ಒಂದು ಶಿ. ಸೊ ದಟ್ ವಾಸ್ ಹರ್ ಸ್ಟೈಲ್, ಇಟ್ ರಿಯಲಿ ವರ್ಕ್. ಅಂಡ್ ವೈಬ್ರೆನ್ಸ್ ಇನ್ ಅಡವೂಸ್, ವಿ ನೆವರ್ ರಿಪೀಟೆಡ್ ಅಡವೂಸ್ ಇನ್ ಅನ್ ಎಂಟೈರ್ ವರ್ಣಂ. ಶಿ ವುಡ್ ಟೆಲ್ ಮೀ ಈವನ್ ವೆನ್ ವಿ ಆರ್ ಟುವರ್ಡ್ಸ್ ಎಂಡ್, ಇಫ್ ಎನಿ ಅಡವು ಯು ಹವ್ ಆಲ್ರೆಡಿ ಡನ್, ಇಫ್ ಐ ಆಮ್ ರಿಪೀಟಿಂಗ್ ಲೆಟ್ ಮೀ ನೋ, ಚೇಂಜ್ ಮಾಡ್ಬಿಡೋಣ ಅಂತ. ತಾಳಗಳು ಯಾವ್ದ್ರಲ್ಲೂ ಒಂದು ಇದ್ರಲ್ಲಿ ಮಾಡಿರೋದು ಮತ್ತೆ ಬರಬಾರ್ದು. ಇಫ್ ಯು ಹವ್ ಡನ್ ವರ್ಣಂ ಸೆಕೆಂಡ್ ಹಾಫ್ ಒಂದ್ರಲ್ಲಿ, ತಿಶ್ರದಲ್ಲಿ ಇಫ್ ಯು ಹವ್ ಫಿನಿಶ್ ಮುಕ್ತಾಯ, ಸೆಕೆಂಡ್ ಒಂದು ಚತುರ್ಶ್ರ ಖಂಡ ದೆನ್ ಮಿಶ್ರ ಸಂಕೀರ್ಣ, ಆ ತರ ಇರಬೇಕು. ಈವನ್ ದ ಕಾರ್ ವೈಸ್ ಶಿ ವುಡ್ ನಾಟ್ ಕೀಪ್ ಇಟ್ ದ ಸೇಮ್. ಒಂದ್ರಲ್ಲಿ ತಕ್ಕಿಟ್ಟ 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 ಗ್ಯಾಪ್ ಕೊಟ್ಟರೆ ಇನ್ನೊಂದ್ರಲ್ಲಿ ತಕ್ಕ ತಕ್ಕಿಟ್ಟ ತಕ್ಕ ತಕ್ಕಿಟ್ಟ ಗ್ಯಾಪ್ ಬರಲೇಬೇಕು. ಸೇಮ್ ಶಿ ವಿಲ್ ನಾಟ್ ಕೀಪ್, ಸಿಮಿಟ್ರಿಕಲ್ ಆಗಿರಲ್ಲ. ಶಿ ವಿ ಯೂಸ್ ಟು ಚೇಂಜ್ ದ ಹೋಲ್ ಥಿಂಗ್, ಬ್ರೇಕ್ ಎವ್ರಿಥಿಂಗ್, ಅಂಡ್ ದಟ್ ಕೈಂಡ್ ಆಫ್ ಅ ಸ್ಟೈಲ್ ಶಿ ಹ್ಯಾಡ್. It was very difficult. If you suddenly go learn from her, no, you will be like, enu na yen aagta ide illi, yen aagta ide illi aa tara, because you won't know where she is coming from. But because we have been there with her, we kind of expect it to be like that. So that was her style, very vibrant, very beautiful, very energetic, because she was a very energetic person, ashtu energy avarige.
Yeah, before we go to the other question related to ma'am, I want to ask you, being a male dancer, okay, this is a very personal question again. As you rightly said, movement of certain kind of organs are kind of, you know, saying no, male dancers, if they do this, it will be more not presentable sorts. So to contrast to that, what you have learned, and especially that expressive abhinayas from and also curvilinear body postures, which do are part of Vadavuru Bani, how do you take that? I mean, what is your take on doing it that way? Or have you curtailed them, saying that no, I will not do because it is a male dancer version of the same action? Or you have done it as it is and you're accepting? What is your viewpoint on this?
What looks good on you, you should do. Just because it is popular or it is looking nice on a shilpam or looking nice in somebody else's photo, you should not do. When you do it, is it looking nice? That is what you have to, that is what I always think. Nan mela chenagidya, if I feel, that way I don't think what others feel. See, I did Purushantargata and all, it is complete feminine, half feminine in the adrali. I've discussed everything from sexuality to cross-dressing to everything in that. I questioned the society's take on it. So, adrali, you have to show various femininity automatically barbeko. So, when you do that, it has to be aesthetic. One, just because you have more of a woman in you doesn't mean you just go throw it on the audience, because without any aesthetics. So, aesthetics irbeko, one, point number one. Two, are you liking seeing yourself like that? Then you should have 4-5 people who will tell you the truth as it is. Like my mother tells me on my face, chenagidre chenagide, adres horrible itto anta direct ag helibidtare, what is this, what nonsense you have done anta helbidtare. So aa tara odu nalak jana beku life alli. You have to perform in front of them and ask them, how was it, did you like it? It is important. That is your first circle of audience. Then you expose to the external audience, then you are safe. And nowadays many of my students, when I choreograph something on myself, I have all my students sitting there, my seniors. It chenagidi, a chenagidi, illa sir chenagila, illa idu chenagila, ad chenagila. So I look at that, how our audience thinking about it. But if I'm very convinced, no, nan hinge maadbeku andre, then I do it like that. So it for me, I don't think about femininity or masculinity when it comes to my dance. It is about aesthetics and it is about what I want to tell the audience.
Subject. Yeah, it's about the subject matter. Yeah.
Correct.
So, yeah.
That's and I've never answer. Been, I've never been inhibitive about that. I have never had inhibitions.
Yeah.
Inhibitions are all, 10 years ago, my teacher threw inhibitions out of the window. So now I have no inhibitions. What I have to do, I will do it.
That's so nice. Because, you know, there's that, you know, especially getting into the next question. I think past what we have seen in the last 10 years, I think not before, we didn't have it when we started learning this dance, and there were not many male dancers too at that point of time. But in some of the newspapers itself, many critics started putting this, how should a male dance? I've read some articles, a male version of Bharatanatyam, and then the male stars of Bharatanatyam, and the way their perspective. So how did this world of critic being influenced by this? Because whomever I have spoken to, even in this conversation and series, there is no gender for any you know, artist. If she's a male, if she is standing as Shiva, then we see Shiva in her. In the similar way, if I'm doing a Devi Kriti as a male or a female, I'm a character there as a Devi. That means I am just replicating the image of imagery of a Devi there. So it's about the subject matter, as you rightly said. But do you think what is the reason for this kind of a misconception which people do have come across? This is a popular misconception, not people who have learned dance for many years and gurus and everybody knows about the truth. But popularly, this is flowing on everywhere. So if you can.
Again, there are two things. There are two things here. One is, if you're doing your stuff really well and yet critics say that, then the critics will not have any worth. Okay. So if they have a good, if most people feel that way, then there's something wrong with you. But what I have seen many critics say is, I have seen people who trying to be bring out that feminine character, making the dance mediocre. I exactly what I'm saying, Alva. See, na nodidini. For example, in the garb of doing Bharatanatyam, I've seen people doing like this. You see, that is like putting down an art. Similarly, just because you have that intense desire to bring the feminine part of you to the world, if you learn the art form perfectly and bring it out aesthetically, there's no reason, there's no rhyme or reason why anybody would feel it is not nice. And if a critic says something like that, despite you having done a fantastic job of it, nobody will take him seriously.
His viewpoint.
See, I've shown birth, I've shown childbirth, other labor pain, and there was hardcore critics in the audience. I didn't get one word saying that you didn't. They are asking me, how did you even know so much? Ishtin research maadidiya. How did you know that inging maartare? How did you know this is how they do midwife works? How hing maadidiya? So that's the kind of questions I had. Nobody told me it was too girlish. Yeah, because that aesthetics irbeko. Then they know what you're doing as an artist. Like if you see a Kathakali Strivesham, never you will feel anything bad about it. They're even dressed up as a woman. They have those false breasts and everything, and they're doing it. You will never feel it is awkward or anything. Ishchanag martare. Bharatanatyam, even if you are not dressed up as a... And even Kuchipudi Nali, there are strivesams, no?
Yes.
Ishchanag martare. How beautifully brilliant they are. Bhagavata Mela. It's not new. It's not something new we have done. Bharatanatyam Nali, the challenge is that you will be bare top, you will be dressed up as a boy. And then sometimes you have to do feminine things. Within 5 minutes, you might become Krishna, and the next second you might become Radha. So when you're Radha, you have to have that feminine beauty come into you. While your body is the same, you're not in Strivesham. And then you again become the charming Krishna. Again, you become a very shy Radha or an upset Radha. So you are just jostling between two, three characters within minutes. So avaga, to be convincingly a feminine, otherwise you look awkward. Alandre, it become cringy. It'll be very cringy when somebody who's so masculine is trying to be a Radha and they are not convincing and they've got inhibitions, then they will become, it'll be cringy. Ayo, you know, antara martha idanata. This is what I think critics are pointing out.
Yeah. Okay. So it's not bad. I think it's like, you know, adding sugar to your coffee or tea. The pramanam is very important. How much you
pramanam.
Add. So
auchityam
that, I think,
also. Yeah, pramanam, yeah. Auchityam. Is it necessary there?
Yes.
Sumne on the adavanna with shaking the waist and doing, is it important? Is it important that you should unnecessarily make something feminine just for the sake of making it feminine? That is not necessary. But when it is needed, if you do it, I think it is appreciated.
Very true. I think with this, we will go to the other aspect because I should not leave those things about Mithun also. So we'll quickly go into the next aspect of your collaborations with different artists, great artists. You have been very, I should say that you are very lucky to be collaborating with such artists like Dr. Ananda Shankar Jayant ma'am or Hema Malini ji and many of them. And even recently also we had a wonderful performance which we all saw online was that marriage, this concept of marriage.
Usha R.K. ma'am's production, Divya Vivaha.
Divya Vivaha. Yeah, I'm sorry for that word. I could not get it. So those kind of concepts and collaborations, what is your view on that? And how? What do we learn from those things? And how is it as an artist? To do
I am
it?
Very, very fortunate, Sagar. I'm very, very fortunate to be able to work with somebody like Padma Shri Ananda Shankar ma'am, to be even in the vicinity of somebody like Hema Malini ji, to be able to work with Pratibha Prahlad ma'am and travel with her so much and listen to her and all of them. Ananda ma'am, Avratra, see, we are doing the production, but there are so many things that you learn when you just sit. And I'm a very inquisitive student. Kutkon tumba questions kelbertini. Our the life, what have they done and how they have brought about their choreographies. Idala kelvaga, you know, it's mind-blowing. And I had a wonderful conversation with Hema Malini ji also because we were on the same flight and the airport and all. So, you know, how she learned, what she loved about dance. Idala kelo Pratibha ma'am atranu, she shares a lot of wonderful things. So, it is my luck. And not only them, so many others. Kritika Subramanyam akka, Gayatri Krishna Veni Lakshmanan akka. With all of them working has been my fortune. And I don't know if anybody else is correct. And Usha R.K. ma'am is like one godmother to me. She has made me face audience, given me challenge after challenge after challenge and brought out the best in me. Because she really liked my Padmini ma'am also. She used to love Padmini ma'am a lot. So she felt that, you know, I have to encourage that boy. Maybe she felt like that. I don't know why and all she has encouraged me so much. But she's done a lot for me. Sudarshana Mirli, with Kiran sir, she gave me an opportunity to work on something. Tyagaraja Vibram Bhavam, with Satya sir, she gave me an opportunity to work. Then my own solo is so many. Divya Vivaham, she, all super hits. Whatever Usha R.K. ma'am has done is super super hits. So Atara Tumba, she has, and all these things. There was a joke also. Recently, one of my friend was telling another one, you know what, this is our great celebrity friend, okay? If you want him to work for you and all, no, minimum on Padma Shri Sikbidbeku ninge. Adad mele only he will come and work. If you don't have Padma Shri and all, Mithun Shyam will not come to you and tala joke martha idro. So maybe it is my luck. With three Padma Shri awardees I have worked, which is three or four, I don't know. Ananda ma'am, Hema Malini ji, and even our Pratibha Prahlad ma'am, they're all super duper legendary life they have had. What kind of, what women they are, my God. To be able to have worked with them and all is my great luck. Yes. So many
do you have? Yes. Do you have any influences of learnings from them to your productions like Purusha Antargata or maybe Sudarshanam or some other productions which you have done?
No. No. I'll mark with one bit. And the best part, I'll tell you what. Al Hodaga, they never try to teach me exactly what they want. Nin body hang barutte hang madu. That is how I've done in the productions. If you look at Ananda ma'am, she is a hardcore Kalakshetra. Rukmini Devi madam, the direct student she is. But you look at my dance is totally me. She
Yours.
Gave me that independence to do. She taught me the actions and I could do how I want. Pratibha ma'am, let me do how I want. Hema Malini ji, total independence. It was like that. So I had, my body could carry how I wanted it. They never imposed anything on me. They just taught me, I could do, they gave me the idea, many actions they taught me, and how it came into my body came out. The Shiva Tandava, Bull and Tiger, what I did with Ananda Ma'am, she showed me the actions and everything. One of her students did. Then it was my world. I could jump, I could lift, I could do what I want. Atara, she gave me the freedom to do it for certain things. So mostly wherever I am, I'm being myself. I've not been changed for their productions. I've never felt like that ever. Because if they tried to do that, I would have had a great difficulty adjusting. So when I danced in Kalakshetra, Kootambaram, imagine my great fortune as a Varuvur Bani Guru Parampara. Because of Ananda Shankar Ma'am, I got a chance to do dance in the Kootambalam of Kalakshetra in front of the greatest, greatest, greatest of Kalakshetra sitting in front of me. And the end of it, the best compliments I heard is that you have your own individualistic style and you did justice to this production with your own style.
Style. Yeah.
Without changing that rawness of your style, you have contributed to this. See, so I've never had to change. Therefore, when I come back, I come back with their work style, their discipline. These are the things I learned from them. If I try to bring it to my class, the discipline that they have. Anita Guha Ma'am, oh my God, I can't forget. Anita Guha Ma'am's production drama, I did know. Hmm. It traveled US and all. So Alli Kaltiddu Eshtu, my God, discipline andre eno. You do the whole drama, ina. You'll get 1 minute break. She'll start from the beginning again. Again, beginning in the again. Like 10 times, 20 times. All the children will just keep dancing like that. And then the kind of dedication, hard work. These are the things I bring back to my class. More than change in the dance style.
That's so nice. That's very nice to hear. Because, it becomes very important for us to, retain who we are.
I've never had to change my personality or my dance.
Yeah, so I think it's the luckiest part that these stalwarts have left you to explore yourself in a given framework so that it fits in to the production which they are doing, and it's not like an odd kind of a situation at any point.
That is why they are so great. No, that is why they are so great.
Yeah, congrats for that, and I think we wish for more and more productions with such stalwarts, and a Padma Shri to you too in future.
There you go.
For your good, great work you're doing. And I think the last question which I would be posing to you is about your preparations for a performance. Generally, for a performance of, say, 1 hour or 1.5 hour, what are your general preferences which you do, probably looking at maybe from the selection of the item to the kind of audience do you consider, or do you want to put up your own perspective on it, or do you want to generally do a thematic one, prefer to do thematic production, given an open choice for you in a situation? So what's your choice for, say, a repertoire of 1-1.5 hour?
For me, first of all, I will see where I'm performing, who is my audience, who is the organizer, and what day is it? Is it falling somewhere near Shivratri? Is it falling somewhere near Thaipusam? Is it falling somewhere near Ganesh Chaturthi? All those things we'll have to see. Then apart from that, when you know the kind of audience, see, if it is a NGO, I have performed Purushantargata, but when it is a Sabha, you should go for a Margam. Your nice. Audience is very important, so you should know what you're, when you're performing in a temple, I don't think I'll ever go to Purushantargata, because that's not what you should present there. In a temple, I go for Margam. I even go for a Veeramani song or something like that. See, it depends on what the audience want to see at that point of time. So for Ayyappa, I have done even that kind of Shabarimala, Il Tanga Suryodayam kind of songs also I have done. So it depends completely on the audience, and the if they give me a theme, yes, I stick to the theme. Like Sudarshanam was a theme. Like Divya Vivaham is a theme. I stick to the theme. Tyagaraja Kriti and Tyagaraja Devu, I will do like that. Otherly, what I can bring my own thought process, one individuality in tarbodu anta yochane madibittu ad madibirtini. Other than that, when it is a margam, again I'll see if I can bring a particular line of thought in my performance instead of confusing the audience. So usually I go for Shiva and different kinds of bhakti to Shiva, or Mahavishnu idre untara different kind of so when I did Sarvam Shivamayam, it was a ICCR Horizon series, so I thought it was near Shivratri. One day before Shivratri. So I thought, okay, let me bring Shiva thing. So how how Papanasan saw Shiva, how Akka Mahadevi saw Shiva, how so different perspectives and padams and thing of Shiva. So Shiva. I stick to that kind so that the audience don't have to, you know, be flustered. Suddenly you are in love with Shiva. The next item you're in love with is San Muruga. The third item you're flirting with Krishna. So they are totally confused. Which ultimately is Paramatma, but Paramatma, but adala explain madakagalvalali. I mean, Jeevatma Paramatma, now who is going to sit and explain? But instead of confusing them, you have a line of thought in your performance. You can take it to various levels and present it to them. So that is how I think when I perform.
That's nice that I think theme in a different way, even, you know, setting the subject is the same, but you have different ways of presenting through different items. That is something which can be an option. Thank you for lighting with all your views, points. And I think it was very interesting. Before we end this show, going on to a very informal, you know, casual discussion of a fire round.
I hope I don't embarrass myself.
No. I should not ask you something which is embarrassing. So pray for that.
Okay, that's good.
Similar one questions which everybody looks out for. So yeah, we'll start with it. What's your favorite spot, travel spot, destination, travel destination?
Nepal.
Favorite food?
Favorite food. See, recently for last 1 year I've been vegan. so in within vegan I love all the vegetables, but especially I like avial.
Okay. Festival. Favorite festival.
Favorite festival. I think Shivratri.
Okay, great.
Something very favorite divine movie. About Shivratri for me.
Great. Movie. Favorite movie.
Tillana Mohanambad.
Oh.
So, Shivaji Ganeshan and Padmini. Yeah, I love it.
Yeah. Okay.
I can watch it 100 times.
That's nice. Hero. Favorite hero.
Favorite hero. Oh my God. Oof. I think I like... oh my God. I can't think of anybody. I can't think of anybody who's my favorite. Madhavan.
Madhavan. Oh, nice.
I like Madhavan for a long time. Yeah, Madhavan.
That's nice. Your favorite place you wish to perform again and again?
Oh, my favorite place I'd like to perform again and again is Tirupati. Tirupati. Nada Neerajanam. Nothing like it. My God, wonderful.
That's nice.
Chidambaram also.
Chidambaram, yes.
Chidambaram and Tirupati is the best.
Your favorite dance item, dance number?
I love Javalis, but nowadays Varnam. I love Varnam.
You like Varnam. I think most of them say the same answer.
Yeah,
so,
it challenges you so much.
I know. Favorite pastime other than dancing?
Reading books.
Oh, you read book? Okay, then your favorite Lord. Book?
The recent one I read, The Undoing Dance. Kumbha Chanagira. This is beautiful. My God.
That's great. Thank you. That was it, Mithun. And before we end the show, do you want to share any message to all of us? We can.
Be yourself. Enjoy your dance. If you are a dancer, you are super lucky. You're really, really lucky that you are able to dance and you've been chosen to dance. Enjoy it. Be happy. Don't use it for name, fame, money, nothing. Use it for your own growth. For your own happiness, for your own spiritual and divine, you know, journey. And that will make your life so rich and so worth it that when you're really old, you'll be like, oh my God, I lived a wonderful life, Anta. But at the same time, this divine thing, if you use it for materialistic things more than the divine journey, then later on you will be unhappy and you will think that you have not lived your life in a good way. But dance generally takes you on the right path, automatically puts you on the right path. So enjoy it. You're all dancers. I think most of the viewers are dancers here. You are lucky that your parents put you and made you dancers, and enjoy that. Have that thrill every day that you're a dancer. Be proud of who you are and stay the same always.
It's a great conversation, though it was sounded too casual, but I think you've given a great message, lot of exposure which people got, and yeah, we wish you all success in your future endeavors, and we also invite you for furthermore collaborations. For sure, sir, not collaborations, because I am very far from all the Shrees which you just mentioned.
Padma Shri. Sagar, you have to get Padma Shri first. You get Padma Shri and then come to me.
I mean to say, for more initiatives of the Sagra in terms of, yeah. I mean to say, performances and shows and your Tiny Tots, wonderful performances. We wish to have it in our own city of Tumkur soon after all this pandemic is over. Thank you so much. For accepting and for enlightening all of them in this night evening. I think it's a wonderful show. Thank you all for being part of this show. Thank you, Mithun.
Thank you, Sagar, for being a fantastic artist and for bringing this show to so many people. Listening to everybody itself makes us, you know, feel like a community, right? And I'm proud in Karnataka how we have that kind of a bond and love for each other. And you are a very good example of that, because you respect everybody, you love everybody, that shows your love for the dance. Thank you for having me on your show.
Thank you, Mithun. Thank you, everybody.
Thanks. Bye.